Hi everyone! Welcome to this vlog, which is quite late as I got sick at the end of May, so it's a little bit longer than usual as I have merged the footage from May and June together. At the beginning of May, we went to Greater Wellington Brew Day and I used my sketch wallet to practice drawing people at the festival. I'd been wanting a sketch wallet since the company first launched a few years back, and I was really pleased to see that they were doing a new Kickstarter campaign last year. This way, no matter what, I always have a sketchbook with me. There are pockets for my cards, and a pocket for a half-size pencil. Rather than using the pocket for the half-size pencil, I have a mechanical pencil in the middle elasticated pocket. This doesn't bulk out the wallet, and it's more convenient and comfortable for sketching. It had been so long since I had sketched while out and about that I was a bit rusty and not used to how quickly people move and change their position. I got a date stamp from Daiso so that I can add dates to my sketchbook. The numbers are a bit bigger than I was expecting, but it's good to look back and know instantly what date I did the sketches. As you can see, the only other time I had used the sketchbook previously was at the beginning of the year. I've only used it once since then as well. Even though it is safe currently to be out and about here in New Zealand, I'm still being a bit cautious and not going out as much as I used to. May was also a month for testing out new product designs. I wanted to try my hand at making my own notepads and bookmarks. These prototypes were super fun to make, and I sent them out to Tier 3 patrons as a fun extra item in their parcels. I printed the pages and then cut them by hand. The design is a pattern I created for a Patreon wallpaper pack. I then used a piece of chipboard to create the backing card for each of the little notepads. I simply place a sheet of the notepaper on top of the card and measure out the correct size. I tried my best to make sure that the stacks of paper were lined up correctly on their backing cards, but this was very difficult and fiddly. I used bulldog clips with little pieces of paper to make sure the clips did not leave any marks on the notepads. I placed the notepad stacks on a piece of card to raise them a little off the desk, and then I stacked some heavy books on top to keep them all in place. I used a palette knife to apply acid-free glue along the edge of the notepad, making sure to cover both the paper and the edge of the chipboard backing card. This worked fairly well, but it was still a bit difficult to apply the glue evenly. I waited until the glue was dry, then lifted off the stack of books on top of the notepads. I was really happy with how these turned out. As a first prototype, they look very cute, but I really would have liked the glued edge to be a little more even. I am going to look into making a press to keep the edges clamped together a little better. Shortly after this, I caught a bad cold which knocked me out for nearly 2 weeks, so I focused on getting my work done but didn't film too much for the vlog. For one of the Patreon art pieces in June, I busted out my Copic markers to create a drawing of a star cactus. This was also the perfect opportunity to test out another prototype I've been working on. You might remember I mentioned a project I was getting laser cut at Pinoco a while back. Well, here are my prototype proportional dividers. Proportional dividers help you measure the size of an object you would like to draw and then to transfer that measurement to the paper you're using. You can also use the dividers to make your drawing bigger or smaller. Once I got the hang of these, I found it quite easy to use them to transfer a measurement at the same size as the original. But I think I'll have to make some adjustments to my prototype, as it's a little fiddly to use to change the proportions of a measurement right now. Thank you. Okay, here's how it's looking. I'm pretty happy with that so far. I definitely feel like, even though the process is slow, because this is the first time I've tried this, I feel like the petals do look better than if I tried to draw them myself, just, by eye, completely, because I've been very careful to measure out certain points before drawing in the rest of the petals, so that's been really, really helpful. So yeah, I will keep working on this, and I will show you guys what it looks like when it's all done. Okay, so this is what I've got. I've gone over the whole sketch with my small eraser and just lightened up those lines a bit. And I just need to do this bit around here in the center because I'm going to fill in this little area with some very pale orangey yellow. So I'm just going to go ahead and lighten this pencil line up here. Then I'm just going to go ahead and fill in this area, and this is YR20, a yellowish shade. And I just put hand cream on so I can't get the top off. Okay, hang on a sec. All right, we're good. Okay, let's go. For that to dry a little bit. And while I'm waiting, I want to go over the stamens in the middle, just like the larger blobby bits of the stamens with some bright yellow. Okay, so the next thing I want is maybe just a light yellow, like not quite this bright, more of a goldenish type yellow to fill in the rest of the circle section here. So I'm just going to have a look and see what I've got, and I'm thinking maybe this pro marker that I've got, which is lemon. Let me see if I've got a swatch for that. Yes, it's this one here, so that looks like a good colour for the centre bit here. So I'm just going to go over that whole centre bit with this lemon colour and see how it looks. Go ahead and wait for these to dry completely so I can see how the colors look together, and then I'm thinking what I might do is add some of this barium yellow, the very light yellow, to the petals, just a layer of color over the whole thing. So we'll come back shortly and have a look at that. Thank you. So here's how it's turned out. These two petals are still a little bit darker because they're still drying, but what I need to do next is add a little bit of orange around the base of each of the petals here, and then blend that back gradually into some golden yellow to about here on each of the petals. Now back here there's kind of more of a greyish brownish tone at the ends of the petals, especially ones that are around this side. I'm not sure if I've got any markers that are actually going to be able to do that, so I might need to go to the art store and just see what they've got. I've had a look on the website and there are a few colours that might do it, but otherwise I'm pretty happy with that so far, and yeah, I'm just gotta keep going and work on some of the details. I'm starting to release limited edition prints on my website, and this first one is of the bucket fountain here in Cuba Street in Wellington. The buckets on the fountain are actually blue, red and yellow, but I wanted to create a print with more pastel colours, so this is my version of the bucket fountain. I was so pleased with how the prints turned out that I decided to test making more notepads, and I also wanted to make some matching magnetic bookmarks. For the bucket fountain bookmarks, I adjusted the design so that it fit into a rectangle and printed out the bookmarks on cardstock. I didn't have a scoring tool on hand, so I used a ruler to carefully pre-bend the bookmark one way and then the other at the fold line. I had some magnetic adhesive strip left over from a previous project, and I wanted to make magnetic folding bookmarks. I cut small pieces of the adhesive magnetic strip and added them to the bottom ends of the bookmarks. I was really happy with how these turned out, but I would like them to be a bit sturdier, and the magnetic strip is possibly a bit too thick. I'm going to look for thinner adhesive magnet sheets, and I would also like the cardstock to be laminated or protected in some way from splashes of water. So I might look into giving them a light spray in the future with acrylic fixative spray. I wanted to make a small square notepad, but I had quite a bit of trouble cutting the squares accurately with my small guillotine. They looked good as I was cutting them, but when I stacked up all the pieces of paper, the notepad turned out to be a little wonky. I'm considering maybe next time using the Cricut so I can cut the sheets in exact squares. This little pad I went ahead and glued together, and I kept it for me so I had a cute little bucket fountain notepad. I also tried a different kind of glue for the second go at making a notepad. I used the Scotch Create Permanent Glue Pen, which has a handy little sponge tip on one side, and this was much easier than trying to use the other PVA glue with my palette knife. Then it was back to the Star Cactus print. With Copic markers, I work in many layers, light to dark, building up the colour bit by bit. While the alcohol ink is still wet, I use a slightly darker colour to start blending the shadows and darker areas together. Here I'm just adding the first layer in a light yellow colour, and I'll later be adding a lighter green over the top of this. I tried my best to leave areas of white where the cactus had some small white spots, but the ink bled a little bit into those areas, and I kept drawing over some of them by accident. In the end, I decided to experiment with masking fluid to see if this would help me reserve those white areas a bit better. I normally use masking fluid with watercolours, so I was quite excited to see if it would also work with Copic markers. It definitely worked best in the darker areas of the drawing, which you'll see later on. I knew that I was going to go ahead and add white gouache highlights to some of these spots, but I wanted to give the masking fluid a go anyway.
Afternoon after the stream, and I've just started finishing off these paintings. You can see this one here is half done. So I'm doing the background with watercolours, but I've also been using these new Arteza gouache paints, which I'm pretty excited about. So the actual plants there, they're all done with the Arteza gouache, so I will finish these off and then they will be ready to be posted.
I was so excited to have this new gouache set to play with. I do already have a basic set of Winsor & Newton Designer's gouache, but only in red, blue, yellow, black and white. This set from Arteza will allow me to play around with more colours and have more fun in my sketchbook with test paintings, so I can see if I want to invest more in gouache in the future. Once I got the hang of working from dark to light rather than light to dark as I would with watercolour, I absolutely love the process. I can't wait to do more plant studies in gouache, especially more houseplant paintings, because I really enjoyed doing this print.
is Monday, June 21st, and I'm just scanning and printing out the gouache print that I did last night, or the gouache painting. I'm scanning it and turning it into a print, but look what arrived in the postbox! Yay! I'm so excited. I can't open this right now because I have to get the print done, but this is the Victorian Animal Family book. So I'm quite nervous and excited to see how this turned out. I'm hoping I will get to unbox it later on this morning, but yes, here it is in a box, and yes, hopefully I will get to see it shortly. Works like there's enough for me to go over, like with some white paint there. It's preserved a little bit of the white. Interesting.
Finally, here is the postcard I sent out to Tier 3 patrons in June. You might remember this Takahe piece as it is an older digital piece, but it is also now available in the shop as a limited edition print. I hope you all have a lovely day, night, evening, wherever you are, and I will be back again soon with more art videos. See you next time!